Prince Nassim Hamed, one of the greatest ever, no doubt. Great personality. You sat down with him and with Evander, not for one, not for two, not for three, but for four hours. Wow. What did you guys talk about for 4 hours?
We talked about any and everything.
Like what? Give me some. Share some knowledge with
him. Okay, some knowledge. He said to me, he goes, buddy, he goes, he showed me a video that he hasn't released of me and Michael Jackson talking in the gym in New York when he was there training to fight Kevin Kelly.
And Michael came to visit you?
No, he came to visit Prince. He didn't come visit me. He came to visit Prince Nassim, but he just happened to be standing next to me talking to me.
So what did he tell you? What did Michael tell you?
He was asking me what was Prince Nassim doing. He was shadowboxing.
Okay.
You know how he shadowboxes. And Mike was asking what was the purpose of it and all that.
He was moonwalking in the ring.
Yeah, basically. But here's the crazy part about that day. No one knew Michael Jackson was coming. And within 20 minutes, there was at least 400 people standing outside the gym.
Wow. He was an icon.
I mean, they had to really call the cops.
So he could leave.
So he could leave. It was crazy, man. I was just like, damn. And then we was talking. And
how did they become friends in the first place?
Hey, God only knows, man. But the funny thing was, he said to Evander, he goes, I love you, brother. He goes, but I don't think that first fight with Lennox Lewis was a draw. Evander said, I don't think it was a draw either. I lost.
Hey, sometimes you can't control the judges, good right. or bad.
And then, but it was great because, you know, I've never really got to sit talk with Evander like that.
He's a great person.
Yeah, he is. So we just sat and talked, and then they both asked me, they said, well, buddy, you know, Prince Nassim said, in your second fight with Pernell, what was your greatest memory? I said, my greatest memory was he hit me with a 20-piece. I knocked him down, and when he got up, I looked at his legs, and he was bouncing. I said to myself, I'm in for a long night. So his sons love when I make this sound. So I said, he walked straight to me, and he hit me, and it sounded like this. Brrr, bing! That was it. The bing was the body shot, because he hit me with like 20 up top, and he dug a body shot. I was like, maybe I shouldn't have knocked him down.
He's one of the greatest ever, too.
Oh, without a doubt. So
greatest southpaw ever, maybe, huh?
Yeah. So we just had, like, we just talked about everything, man. And it was a lot of fun. And the only reason we stopped, because it was 2 in the morning.
You would have continued it.
Forget about it. We would have continued without a doubt. It was great. We had a lot of fun, you know, and just kicking the old breeze, man, you know.
It's funny because Evander's very cool, very calm.
Yeah.
Prince Nassim is, like, on 15 Red Bulls at all times. He's always, like, on, like, winded up. Like,
exactly.
So it's a weird, and you're in the middle somewhere.
Yes, exactly. But you know, that day I was excited because, you know, honestly, as long as I've known Evander, that was the most we've ever talked.
Wow.
That, I put it to you like this, that day, those 4 hours, was the most I've talked to him in 10 years. You know what I mean? Like,
I believe it.
For that long period of time, you know what I mean? So, but it was a great experience. I mean, his it was great, man. I enjoyed it. And in all honesty, I feel that. We got to do more of that. We got to get more of the older fighters together just to reminisce and kick the bullshit.
Maybe do some tour, like city tours.
That'd be great, you know.
I think it would work in the UK. In the UK, they do stuff like that. Yeah. Right? And it would work. But how did you and Nassim end up in the same gym?
I was training guys. It was in Blue Velvet Boxing Gym in New York. And I was training guys there. And the owner said, everybody has to leave in an hour. Prince Nassim is coming. So we was packing up, getting ready to leave, and Mr. Brendan Eagle, God bless him, he came in, he saw me. He goes, where you going? I said, they said I had to leave the gym. He goes, you're not going anywhere. He goes, you stay and watch Prince train.
So everybody else?
Everybody else had to go, and his trainer, Mr. Eagle, let me stay. And me and him talk boxing for a while, you know, until Prince Nassim got ready, and then, damn, bam, Michael Jackson walked in.
What was it like to watch Prince Nassim in his prime? Because I'll tell you this much, buddy. If there was social media like there is now, back then, he would have had 50 million followers, easy.
Easy, without a doubt. It was an experience, you know, just watching him, you know, work out, you know, the crazy moves he make, and it's like, okay, he does it in the fight, does he do it in the gym? And he does it in the gym. He did it when he did
Mitch. He jumped over the ropes.
You know what I mean? Everything, you know, the crazy moves that he made.
And, the Matrix.
Yes, all that. When he's doing Mitch, when he was hitting the heavy bag. So it was a great experience, man. And, you know, it was a lot of fun. I was like a kid in a candy store, you know?
So Michael Jackson walks in the gym. You didn't expect it, right?
No.
So what was your first reaction when you see Michael? If this is a gym. Used to be a massage parlor. So every 10 minutes, you have people walking in, making a U-turn and leaving because they wanted a massage. But
right.
Michael Jackson walking in the gym?
He walks in, and here's the crazy
part. By himself?
No, he had a couple of people with him. But no bodyguards. He had no bodyguards. The crazy part is that I was standing, you know, by the ring, and he walked right over to where I was standing and stood right next to me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then we started talking, and then when Prince Nassim started losing shadow boxing, Michael Jackson asked me, he's like, well, why is he doing it? What is that he's doing? I said, it's called shadow boxing. He goes, why? I said, to get him loose before, you know, he starts working out. He was like, oh. And he goes, he's crazy. You know, he was saying he was crazy, the moves he was making. I said, that's the Prince, man. So
he did things different.
Yeah, so it was a hell of an experience, man, you know. And then watching him train was great.
You know what's wild? Like, Kobe Bryant came to visit Manny Pacquiao. I've seen Justin Bieber come to visit, like, Floyd. Over the years, I know, who came to visit Ali? Was I, like, I want to say the head of the mob at the time or someone? Like, Ali had some major, major heavy hitters come visit him. Who did you have, like, that you've seen besides Michael Jackson come to gyms? Like, celebrities or superstars?
Well, when I was fighting, I had a bunch of mob guys.
Hey, they were fans.
But yeah, exactly. I had a bunch of mob guys that came to see me train. And, which later on down the road created a little havoc, but you know, that's a story within itself. But that was basically it. When I was fighting, a lot of former world champions would come see me. Like Jersey Joe Walcott lived in Camden. I trained in Jersey City. So he would come 2 to 3 times a week. He would have his son drive him down to watch me train.
I just watched his fight with, what's his name? Marciano.
Oh, and he used to come watch me train, and after we trained, we'd go have lunch, and I would just pick his brain, man. Great man, great fighter, you know what I mean? Willie Pep used to come watch me.
No way.
Joey Giardello, Rocky Graziano, Jake LaMotta.
All those guys?
All those guys.